Welcome to the Enjoying Your Life channel. Have you ever just wanted to get a good stretch? Well, today I have a treat for you. I'm over at the Stretch Zone in Chattanooga, Tennessee, and Jacob Smith took real good care of me. Have you ever heard of the Stretch Zone? Today was my first time ever hearing about it. But you best believe that I'll be back. It felt so good, as they say, it hurts so good. Become a subscriber, like the video, and enjoy.
Do a little warm up, okay? So you're gonna feel my hands go underneath your heels. Yep, so just keep those legs as nice and relaxed. And what I'm gonna have you do is take a deep breath. Perfect, and on that deep breath, we're gonna. This right here is called a spinal decompression. It's just there to relax the lower back.
Well, my husband's got 72
back. Then we're going to do one more deep breath. And breathe out.
All right. Cool.
Okay. So, what you're going to do is you're going to feel me spinning your legs, okay? So, this right here is just to kind of warm the hips up, kind of relax the blood and start flowing through it. We don't ever want to stretch any muscles warm or any cold muscles. We always want to warm up before stretching. That's what we're doing here. Alright, so it is now time for your range of motion test, okay? So we're going to bend this left knee first. Perfect. Can you just relax? So I'm going to push your foot inward, so whenever you start feeling some tightness in your hip, let me know. Okay. So what we're looking for, just a little bit. We don't want a lot of stretching, we just want a little bit, okay? So you're at 70 degrees there. The reason we're just looking for a little bit is because whenever it comes to the range of motion, that small tug lets us know when the range of motion has ran out and the muscle's starting to stretch. And so that's kind of what we're looking for.
I feel it, but I feel it also because I've been doing yoga class.
Yeah, so right there, I'm just warming your calves up. Yeah, we're not doing a range of motion test on your calves. So we're going to do range of motion test on your hamstrings now, okay? So just relax. Let me know when you feel the back of the legs here. So you get to about 70 degrees there as well. So that's a plus. That means your hips and hamstrings are about the same.
Is that how you do today?
You bend this knee.
Yeah.
We're gonna do the same thing, okay?
Tight and old.
I know last time you said you wanted your neck today. Kind of
talked about that.
So
we're
around the neck.
Nice. 70 there too.
So move to your hips.
That means you don't have side to side balance. That's always a plus. You don't believe the amount of people are side to side now. You're going to pressure on one side. Alright, so same thing. Hamstrings.
Yep. Are you feeling it in your neck?
Just let me know.
Are you feeling it in your neck? Kind of through the straps?
So 70s all the way around. What that means is, so just to kind of put it in perspective, we want you to be able to go 90 degrees. So we want your hips to be able to get 90 degrees and before you start feeling cold. So just kind of let you know the hair off from where we want you to be. Right? Because that's when the body can really start being functional and you're going to be stressful, right? So what I'm going to have you do is I'm going to have you put your hands on your stomach for me just real quick. Perfect. So this right here is going to wrap around your waist, okay? This is here to pretty much just kind of hold your waist down. It keeps it from moving side to side on this. So do you have a preferred side you'd like to start on? Okay, so I'm left-handed, so we'll start on my left, right? So I'm just going to lay that leg right there. I'm going to bend this knee. I'm just going to lay this right here. So what I'm going to do now is wrap this strap right here around your right leg. Because this one is here to pretty much just hold your right leg down, and it keeps the right leg from helping us. You'll feel the right leg kind of move a little bit and kind of want to help out. Do it. So it's just kind of good. Okay. So just going to relax the leg down. So we're going to be stretching your IT band, your TFL, your hoses, your grand forearms first. So you're going to stretch your IT band first.
Alright,
you're going to need
another
one. Alright, so this is with it.
3 5 seconds.
Alright.
I don't remember. I remember something on Monday.
That's a good question. You know, you have 3 buttons.
Yeah, but I don't have that.
I'm going to look for a rest.
If I have tomorrow, there's no Saturday, I'm in trouble.
Seven here, okay? Now this is a deep stretch, but no pain. So let me know. Okay. No pain, right?
Okay. Well, only because I've been doing some things. Like,
okay. Okay.
Monday 11:30.
Okay. Okay. So we're gonna stretch your TFL. So right here, okay. Let me bring your leg down, kind of pull. Let me know if it's free. All right, so now's your piriformis, okay? Piriformis is a deep back pocket muscle. It's right up underneath your glutes, more towards the upper portion of the glute, okay? But underneath it, you'll see what it's on. So I'm going to do, I'm going to place your foot right here, or just like that. I'm going to push you in. So that's what we're here for, right? Is it's pretty much just to kind of help increase your flexibility, your range of motion, functionality, mobility, right? By stretching, it causes more blood flow through the body, it allows more blood flow through the body, which, you know, just allows more mobility, less pain, and it keeps the muscles from constricting, right? So it allows them to kind of die, kind of like when you stretch a straw, real thin, it gets real nice and tiny, because it adds to a muscle whenever it gets tight. And so by kind of stretching it more and more,
you got the car as well.
That's what our main goal is.
How many days a week do you suggest people come in?
It really just depends on the person, right? So, depending on tightness, are we having issues or not having issues? So, like, for the average person, it would be about twice a week. Simply because, you know, the average, our average clientele have some sort of a problem, or they have some sort of pain that's causing them, or they're just extremely tight, right? And so we're working on pretty much restoring them, getting them back to where we want them to be, right? Other people, so like, you would be a good example, right? So those that are above average, we would look at seeing coming in like once a week. Coming in a little less, not coming in as often, but still coming in enough, where you're going to see the difference within the So, upper back, okay? What we're going to do here is I'm going to put my foot on the table. I'm going to have to grab my forearm with your right hand. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a step back. And I'm going to pull you this way, okay? It's going to stretch the major muscles of the upper back. And so here, there's no 3-5 set, okay? It's just whenever you feel a good, comfortable stretch. That's where I'm going to stop. Whenever you get to that point,
yeah, pretty parts for sure.
Stop. I'm going to hold out there right since I get a second. Okay, so if you will, put that left hand over your stomach for me, just like that. Okay, so grab my forearm. So grab my forearm. Yeah, perfect. Just go like that. All right, so take a deep breath for me.
So
I'm going to breathe out. I'm off in the pool.
So, okay.
So just let him know I'm feeling a nice deep stretch.
Don't
breathe.
Okay, that makes a lot more sense. Stack those hips. Straighten them down. Let's get back into it.
How'd I do?
That I need more of that in my life.
Okay, so what I'm having to do now is act like you're hugging yourself.
Okay.
Perfect. So I'm having to take a deep breath.
Yeah.
You're going to feel me reach over, and I'm going to grab right here, and we're going to do the same thing. Okay, so this right here is, as you can tell, it's kind of stretching more internally. It's stretching kind of the muscles that surround your spine.
Well, it's the fact that it just happened after you're overheated, it's just trying to figure out, get you a long head gasket.
Right, you're getting relaxed. How'd that feel?
No power. Well, you just overheated once before, pretty much.
So we're going to do your calves and hamstrings now, okay? So we're going to do the head of the calf first. So right here. So let me know when you feel this 3 here.
IT band here. First 3.
3, 5, 7.
Last one I went first started. A little bit more than when
we
first started.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's go down. Check the
radiator, it's full radiator. It's out of hole.
Okay.
We first
started barely at a pool
and it was
growing.
My
oil
change.
We're
still very tight.
How you doing? You good so far?
Okay.
So we're going to do hamstrings. There's 3 heads to the hamstring. So we're going to do your outer head first. So we're just going to roll those toes out.
Before that point.
So you're gonna feel this on the outside portion of your hamstring, okay? Let me know if it's 3.
Okay. And right upstairs, so it's as simple as just that hips. That hips.
Five.
And as I'm going into the stretch, and out as I'm kind of holding the stretch.
Right. Okay.
Okay.
I go off facial expression, so I like to ask.
What about the right one? 3. Rattle. Racket going that rattle. That'd be a valve.
I think I'm stronger in my left leg than my right. I tried to hold him up yesterday and this one kind of shook and this one was okay.
That's good. Alright, so we're going to get toes in. So this right here is going to stretch the internal portion of your hamstrings, okay?
The difference?
So everyone feels 3.
I feel it.
Yeah.
So
you're going at the glutes.
5, 3, 5, 5 and 7.
7,
This one right here, right down the center. Okay. So three.
Tighter
than the non-tight hip. All right, so this leg is done. How's it feel? Is there a difference?
Yes.
It's like one's like blood's kind of flowing through one and the other?
I do.
Okay. Play golf.
Yeah. So we're going to bend that knee?
No.
No. Just kind of lay it here.
Four.
I'm going to
hold this. The group is up to 16.
So what we're doing here is just the exact same. Just the other side.
Four. Five. Six one time.
So you said you think your left leg is worse than the right leg?
No,
well, think about this.
Oh, okay, see, so you think the right leg is
four, huh? Three.
All right. So, same thing. Relax, I got it.
Yeah. Like I said, you got the brand new.
All right, you ready? IT band, so outside of the leg.
This is, yeah, this isn't the same.
So, no, you feel this is three.
For the band, it's not. That's the right side.
Three.
That's what I thought I remember. It was just, it was opposite what you thought it would be. It was much tighter than not hurting. Yep.
So that five.
Okay. Five.
This one does feel a little tighter, huh?
Yeah, it does.
Seven. Deep stretch, no pain. Yeah, that was actually your five on the other side.
Other side?
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so this right leg is just a hair tighter. All right, TFL. Outside the hip, okay?
Relax.
Feel the
difference on that left or that right side?
Yeah.
Glutes now, okay? It actually, I mean, it would just prevent just a lot of tears, to be honest with you. it would help kind of prevent a lot of like muscles in the knees. So like your ACL, PCL, and stuff like that, it would kind of help them from tearing because you're strengthening and flexing the muscles more in your knees. So it's allow them to get a little more comfortable so they're not getting too tight. Most thing that we see is in like younger athletes.
Is,
you know, you're kind of telling them to stretch. Joking around with their buddies, having random time. So when we bring them up, there's a 17-year-old kid that comes in, and he's a baseball player. I think his hamstrings are like a 30. Could barely move
them. I could see the courts at Rivermont.
The outdoor same with his upper back.
I mean, they don't even get enough play at all.
Because he wasn't really stretched.
Not that I know of anyway.
And so quickly become 18 pickleball courts.
I come to Rivermont, but you don't know about
the school. I feel like you were the only one that got off, and this would be stronger. Because sometimes in pain, I don't know if I'm going to need to change my mattress or not, but I would feel it right here. I'm thinking if I did this.
Usually for a lot of side slippers. Common muscle to get tired. It's because you're constantly putting pressure on it, and you've got to think 8 hours of sleep. You're laying on it on that side for 8 hours. So then when you wake up in the morning, you're taking the pressure off.
Five.
Seven.
You're going to say, finally.
Yeah.
Okay. Hand over your shirt. Okay. So I'm going to have you grab my forearm with your left hand. Perfect. Take a deep breath for me.
That's great, too.
Just let me know if it's...
Can we do that one more time?
Three, five.
Let's see if I can pull it deeper.
Good outside entry?
Yeah. Ah, that's what you feel. That's what my friend feels when he always says, that stretch in the morning. Okay,
nice, isn't it?
Good deal, yeah.
All right, same thing, I can remember yourself.
Okay.
Perfect, deep breath. Gas and hamstrings now. All right, ready? Hands at the calf first. Set three.
So is that people not running in at all?
No.
I just have a run. I haven't put it back on the road. If you get
all right, hamstrings in, okay? So we're gonna go out.
I'm good.
Perfect. Outside portion of your hamstring.
Your back is facing me, and you're looking outside.
Three.
It's got one problem.
This is best to just ever so slightly higher.
Can you bring your knees up to that
blue strap? Look up the mass there.
It's like a few degrees, just a little tighter. Toes in.
Perfect.
Inside portion of your hamstring. Three.
36. But I haven't.
Shoo. It's right there.
Prepare. Yeah, it's just a simple prepare.
Four, five.
You just have the one grandkid?
Yeah, he's going to be a big brother, good Lord willing, and man.
Nice.
Another little brother.
Cute. How old is he?
Was two and
you got the
back with her.
Mm-hmm. You're probably throwing them back because you're kind of helping out there. And with how tense the muscle was and how tense you were getting.
Yes, your leg was going to come back.
Really? Okay. And so you have the 22nd?
And push that. You know what I mean? It's kind of pretty bad. Forcing things to go.
First, real stuff.
You want to try again?
No.
Okay. So you got the quadricep here? So you have your knees?
And then
first. Please let me know.
That's happy. I don't want to cut from the transmission.
Yeah. Good for that 5 here?
5.
Probably a $700 valve in the garage.
And then that side.
Oh, not about nowadays. Oh yeah, might be more than that.
I worked on this.
Everything's $700 out for free.
How you doing? Good so far?
Good.
All right, last stretch. So this last stretch is your lower back, okay? So the way this works. So we do your left side first, so we're going to do your left side first right here, okay? So what we're going to do is we're going to bend this knee. We're going to put it just like we did with the upper back. So the difference is what I'm going to do here is I'm going to be pushing your knee to your right. I'm going to hold that under your left shoulder. Whenever you feel just a deep stretch on your lower back, let me know. Same thing as upper back, I'll stop and I'll hold it. All right, so I'm going to place my hand here.
Thank you guys for stopping by. Please don't forget to like the video and become a subscriber. And as always, I love you. And until next time, goodbye.